Well, listen to those seagulls, huh? All right, me buckos and buckettes, welcome back to the Gaming Galleon. I'm Cap'n Riz, and I just want to tell you, the sea looks bright, it looks briny, it looks salty, and it looks ready for fun. And I hope that you're ready for fun, because that's what we're going to be doing today. I'm hearing, like, a dog. Do you hear that? Does that clue you in, give you any ideas to where we are this week? We're deep in the Midwest. And I mean, if that, I don't know if you can hear that, but if that's not the sounds of the Midwest, the dog off in the distance. This week we're going to be we're docked in Bourbonnais, Illinois, which is really not very far from Indianapolis, where the ship is usually docked throughout the week. We're out here because I'm selfish. I'm selfish, and I wanted to be in Bourbonnais a little bit more. My family lives out there, and I've been out there for past couple weekends, and let me tell you, it's been paradise. It's been absolute paradise. And a big part of that is my father got a pool. Have you ever had a pool? You ever had that? I mean, I've never had that. But have you ever had access to a pool just anytime you wanted? I've been in a couple hotels like that. But, you know, you're usually with some doof who's, you know, looking at you funny. Or like, you know, two people who have a room, but they're not getting a room, if you know what I mean. So to have access to a pool is like crazy talk. Oh, another addition. See this? Thrift store. $2. Brand new. It was in the packaging. We're already 2 minutes and 36 seconds in. Talk about it. Exact, huh? That's great. So as a result, every weekend I've been free, these past two weekends, I've gone down there. Another reason is my sister just had a baby. Little April. Pretty cool. I guess that makes me an uncle again for the second time. And, you know, I don't know much about kids. I mean, I pretty much am a kid. I mean, look at me. You know what I mean? If anything, kids, okay, I'm getting jeered over here in the mess hall. I just want to make sure they're not like, hey, you idiot, you forgot the music, or something like that, so we're fine. Jeer away, my friends, jeer away. But they live in a very different area than I live. You know, we live in Indianapolis, and it's a big city. You know, I'm always tooling around the highways and the byways and the alleys, looking for games. You know, it's not totally out of the realm of possibility that I or one of my friends gets held up. You know, not in the streets, but, you know, I hang around pawn shops. You know, it happens. Not often, but, you know, one minute you're looking at, like, a Sega Genesis controller, the next minute, you know, the clerk is being held up. But that's another story for another day. You know, it's a very different world than Bourbonnais, Illinois, where my family lives. It's about a 2.5-hour drive, and about an hour and a half of that is cornfields to get there. So I don't know if you've lived in that kind of world. I grew up in the suburbs outside of Chicagoland, and then from there I moved to a college town. And then after I got my degree, I moved from city to city, you know, pretty much all over the country. So while my college town was kind of country, it's still a college town. But you get into these real country towns, and it's this mix between flat-out country and the suburbs. Because, you know, corporate America is pretty much found its way into every nook and cranny of the country. You know, you're not going to find... pretty much every place has a 7-Eleven. You know, Bourbonnais may be, you know, an hour from Chicagoland, but they still have, you know, Noodles and Company and Panda Express. You know, so it's not like, you know, we're not talking about, you know, the sticks here. But it's certainly a big departure from being in the city. And I think the biggest part of it, the biggest departure is just what you can do. The coolest thing about Indianapolis is if you're a retro gamer or a gamer of any kind, if you're a dork, you're going to find stuff to do. There are other dorks around. You put enough people on top of one another in a concentrated area, and you're bound to find people with, like, interests. I think that's a little harder in Bourbonnais, especially for me. You know, if you're talking about the kind of hunts I can go on, about halfway between Indianapolis and Bourbonnais is Lafayette, Illinois, Indiana. That's a college town. I think Purdue's there. And I've been, you know, they've got some game stores there, so I'll usually be able to find, you know, some interesting stuff there. But once you get into Bourbonnais, it's like there's nothing left. There's like one game store, and the guy's pretty much totally working off eBay and higher. You know, he's got enough clientele where kids will be coming in who don't have credit cards and can't order online, so they're pretty much at the mercy of whatever he's charging. You know, I'm not going to say that the guy's robbing people blind, but he's certainly not as, you know, he doesn't have to cut deals as much as, say, you know, a franchise pawn shop. So it's a very different world, and it can be kind of boring. I mean, I have had some really boring weekends in Bourbonnais, Illinois, but I mean, man, you add a pool into that mix. I'll tell you what. Can that be a story for right now? You really want to know about the holdup? Do we have time? All right, we have time. I think we have time. Yeah, Barnyard. We're gonna play Barnyard in a second. We'll get into the chest. Three really cool deals in the chest. One's okay, but two were good. And then, a little more Barnyard, and then, of course, your questions and queries in the mailbag here. And I guess we have a minute. It's not a long story. This was like 9 in the morning at a pawn shop. I'm standing across a glass cabinet filled with, like, you know, game stuff. And the clerk's on the other side, you know. So I'm here, and, you know, she's there. And I'm looking over the merchandise. And the two of us at the same time look down toward the main register, and we see the manager being held up by a man in a mask with a knife. And the manager is like back like this because he's like, the guy wants him to open the register, but the manager, maybe it wasn't the manager, but whatever, for whatever reason, this guy who is at the register didn't have the key. Oh my God, is it really nighttime in Barnyard already? Wow, I'll have to fix that on the fly. Well, I'm glad we went to this, we had this story. So anyway, we see this exchange happening, right? And he doesn't have the key, so he looks at the clerk, the lady who's dealing with me, and she's like, all right, so she has to go and confront the guy who's got the knife and open the register. Now, meanwhile, I'm on the other side of the, you know, I'm on the safe side of the register, opposite side of these people, and I just kind of slink away into the aisles. I was playing a lot of The Last of Us multiplayer back then, so my stealth skills were up, and I let it finish up. The guy got the whole shebang out of the register and keel hauled it out of there, and then it was like there were only four of us left. There was maybe four or five of us left, but it was like the two workers, myself, and then a couple other of customers, And the manager's like, well, you guys better get out of here before the cops start show up and detain you for questioning. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I got to go. I'm on my lunch break. So meanwhile, there's another guy. And I'm on my way up. But meanwhile, there's another guy who's going up to the register with some stuff. And the man, the girl I was talking to is still at the register. She had the key. She's like, what are you doing? And this guy's like, oh, yeah, I'd like to buy these. She's like, we just got robbed, dude. He's like, what? She's like, yeah, didn't you see the knife? He's like, oh, I had no idea. So obviously she and I were exchanging glances on that, so. Okay. We're over time, dude. Barnyard for the PlayStation. No, for the Nintendo GameCube. Man, do I love this game. Let's get started. Let's be a cow. And this one goes out to my my dear, sweet, innocent niece, April. All right. Harper transition. Give me some audio. I need to pause it. Put some video here. And here we go. So let me tell you something about Barnyard. Yeah. All right. So we're playing a cow. Okay. Oh, and it looks like I got a text message on my cell phone. Because cows have cell phones, right? Let's take a look at it. Hannah the chicken says, she sounds kind of boring. Okay, this is a baby chicken. Wants to see me in the barnyard. Otis is like this other cow friend of mine. He wants me to meet him at Dankweed Pond. We could go over there. Who knows what's going on there? And then finally this guy, Joey, is a gopher. And he says he'll pay double for every block of butter we can sell them. So let's, that's a great idea. You know, it's the morning here in the barnyard, and I'm pretty hungry, so I tell you what, let's make some butter. Let's make some ingredients to make some chocolate mousse, shall we? Okay, so here we are in the barn, and you know, we are a cow. It's still morning, so some people are still sleeping, but you know, I'm hungry. So, we're going to make some butter. And how else would a cow make some butter? Yeah, right. Okay. All right, now do I want to keep the milk? No, I want to make some cream. Shake her up. Okay. And I want to churn her into butter. Yeah, there we go. All right. Great, so we got some butter. We're going to need a little more cream. We're going to make some chocolate mousse. Now, I bought some chocolate off the gophers last night. Shake her up. All right, cool. So we got cream. I want to keep the cream, please. Thank you. And then we'll make one more of our special sauce for the gophers. I'm making my own milk, Ma. All right, there we go. Good. Okay, so we'll be able to get. We'll give the. We'll meet the gophers later on tonight. We've got a big day on our plan, though. Living on a barnyard, you'd have, on a farm, you'd have no idea. Now, what's up with this? The cows. So yeah. It's a busy life as a cow. But why is a cow? Why are the cows walking on 2 feet? Why has this guy got a clipboard? Here's the thing. The farmer goes to the city every day. And when the farmer goes to the city, it's our time to play. Okay? But the last thing you could do is let him know what's going on. But all the farmers... Oh, yeah. Let's make breakfast. We got some cream. We got some butter. We got some chocolate. And I'm hungry. Okay. cookbook. I want to make some chocolate mousse. Oh, okay, so I have to add chocolate, an egg, and we only have one more egg. And then, was it butter? God, I hope that's right. Oh, no, it's cream. So, cream. Okay.
I'm gonna make something swill.
Hook me up, baby. All right. Now, that's a healthy way to start off your day, huh? Get me out of here. All right. Yes, I'm ready to leave.
Hurry on.
All right, here we go. Okay, so let's eat our food. Where's that chocolate mousse at? Can I eat it? Oh, you're kidding! Alright, I'll just eat the chocolate. I wonder... Alright, whatever. Okay, now, let's go over here. Let's have some fun with the pig. This pig here. See, this is where the pigs hang out. It's all muddy. But they have this awesome game called Mud Skippers, or Mud Jumpers. There we go. Let's play some Mud Jumpers. Oh, man. Welcome to God's country, huh? In the stink. I gotta go for this other black one. Ah! Ah! Alright, piggy, me and you. Oh! Ah! Not bad. Not too bad. Killer. So the coolest thing about these mini games is they're all scored. And I really like that because you can always go for a high score. Of which I'm pretty good at this. I beat my old high score. Alright, now seriously, how can you not be in love with this game? Alright, now we're going to play one more little game here and then we'll come back for the booty segment. This is hilarious. What's this one called again? Right. Chase Chickens versus Otis. Now, Otis was the other cow that we know. He's a good guy. Alright, self-explanatory. The cutscenes, they explain themselves. Now, why the sunglasses? Because they need to be incognito for what's about to happen here. So we have to grab as many chickens as we can and then throw them back into the chicken coop. But Otis is out there too. There's one. And Otis is already ahead. Oh my god, come here! There's Otis. Watch this. Come here, you! Get milked! Oh man, this guy's way off. Come on. We're getting creamed. No pun intended. So you gotta pick up milk for ammo. So you can do that disgusting action over and over again. But Otis is really killing us. And I don't see him anywhere. He's being like the Artful Dodger. I want to, like, assault him a little more. Where is he? There he is. Yeah. See that? Oh, where? What's this special area? Throw it! Oh, wow! So that's how you could beat me, huh, Odie? Playing he sprayed me! I don't have a lot of time left. I'm out of milk. Oh, I need one more of those. I'm out of chicks. Oh man, he beat us. That sucks. I beat him before. Alright, we'll wrap it up there. Oh, F! Ouch, it's like college all over again. Alright, let's wrap it up there. That's some catchy music right there. Thank you. Alright. Okay, booty segment. Booty time. I screwed this up. I'm gonna. Oh, I am batting 1,000 today. I'm sorry. I'm all over the place. Okay, chest. 3 great deals. Well, all right, one's not that great of a deal, but I think a lot of you out there will appreciate it. Probably more so than me, but I thought it was a good deal at the time. Anyway, let's check out. Let's see what we got here. Okay, so the first one. I was at a pawn shop, big surprise, one lazy morning, and I had come across a bunch of PS3 games on the wall, nothing to write home about, but I saw one that looked a little off to me. That's how it looked on the rack. Demon's Souls, okay? Very common, very respected game. A game I played all the way through. I'm pretty sure this is the first game I played on PS3. Seriously. But anyway, if you know your box art, if you're an idiot, if you're a complete idiot like me, you're gonna recognize that this box art is not like most Demon Soul spines. A little off, and when I pulled it out, I noticed that this is definitely not the same picture that I usually see on all the Demon Souls carts that I come across, discs I come across. And on the back, well, it's obvious we're not in Kansas anymore. Okay, now how did this end up in a pawn shop in Indianapolis? Well, here's the thing. When Dark Souls first came out, it was very exciting. People were very excited about it coming out. And there were rumors that it might not make it to U.S. shores. So as a result, there were a number of people so excited about this game that they imported the English-Chinese version. So this is a Chinese import. Not Japanese import, believe it or not. The Chinese version, for whatever reason, was also dubbed in English. So there were a whole lot of people here in the mainland, in America, who imported this guy from China. Now, does this make this some sort of rarity? Not really. Not really. But I think it's a fascinating... Here, if you look at the manual there, that's the American box art. That's what you're going to see on every Dark Souls disc you come across. Not this one, which arguably is a little cooler. I like that the guy's dead right on the cover. He's got arrows all over him. So yeah, it's $5. It was $5. Do we need this? No. We already have Demon Souls. But this is completely playable. So, you know, exactly as competent as the American version. And I think the historical significance of this, plus, you know, it's a great game, was worth picking up the Chinese version. Fascinating. In addition, when I brought it up to the counter and paid for it, I also saw in the cabinet he had a Nintendo game. Batman Returns. He had it for $8. I asked him if he'd do $5. He waited for a while there, and then he was like, all right. So we got both of these for 10. Is this a huge deal? No, but this is certainly a good deal on Batman Returns. And this is just an oddity. I think it's totally cool. All right. Oh! There goes Batman Returns. I hurt my foot this morning. I was grabbing food from Qdoba. I was getting the nachos. You get the chips on the side. If you get the chips on the side, then they pretty much fill the whole bowl with, you know, meat and queso and what have you. It's good value. And I got it all the way back to work, and then I realized, which is like a 5-minute walk, and I realized that they didn't put the chips in the bag, so I had to walk all the way back. I had a drink and nachos. I showed back up there with the nachos, with the bowl of queso, and I said, I think you guys forgot to give me my chips. And he said, oh, sorry about that. He gives me the chips, and then he gives me a free drink. I'm like, I already have a drink, but maybe I could get, like, some cherry limeade high C, something that's going to keep for the voyage. And so I've got this, you know, large size, no ice, because I didn't want it to melt or water down, thing of cherry limeade. And then I've got the bag of nachos. And then I'm walking, and there's like a church, like a kind of like a big church with a, you know, big wooden steps, and there's some sort of very small 10-person wedding, and the bride was, you know, very attractive and overweight, which, you know, can be a good thing, gentlemen. Don't go judging. And so I'm kind of distracted, and my foot catches a curb, like one of the garden curbs, and it's like Shadow of the Colossus, baby. I mean, the drink just went psh, like a good 30 feet. I totally twist my ankle. I mean, I'm okay. Skinned my knee a bit. I could have been a lot worse. I mean, I'm old enough where I gotta be worrying about my hips these days, okay? So, anyway. Alright, here's a good deal. Your basic situation of walking in and seeing maybe a game or two on the shelf, but then asking and seeing what else they have, and working out pretty good. In fact, I don't think there was anything. I think all these were in the back. So we're doing PS2 games, $2 each. All right? And they brought out a whole bunch, so you had to pick and choose. It wasn't like it was just this group. Oh, but before they show me the PS2 games, I'm like, did you see any carts? It's like, yeah, I think so. Well, look at what she came out with. Ah, I'm so butterfly. And now it's like it hurts. Oh, my God. Oh, jeez. Oh, I should have taken some Advil. Okay. You got golf? Hey, it's Nintendo golf, okay? It's a great game. You'd be shocked how much I've played this baby. Not in the best condition. In fact, it's got the McVans video trader on the back there. But this was a buck. And then also, with it, for the N64, believe it or not, for $1, we got Paper Mario. Don't see this guy floating around too often. So that was pretty neat. Alright, as for the PS2 games, real nice lot here. The worst of the bunch is Evergrace. This was, I believe, a launch title for the PS2. And I believe, I meant to look this up. Oh yeah, it is. Okay. Cool thing about Evergrace is, who makes this? From Software. Our Demon Souls friends. Okay? I think the biggest sell here was, it was a pretty boring RPG, but you could actually, what the gear that you found would actually show up on your character, which was a big deal in the PS2 days, especially the early PS2 days. Resident Evil 4, very hard to keep, very hard to not grab this one when you see it for $1 or $2. Even if we have it, Christmas is coming and people love this game. And for whatever reason, it's got the Onimusha too. So it's not complete. But, disc is good shape. Yeah, that's not bad for a buck. If you haven't played this, you probably should. And I haven't played it. Don't I suck? Champions of Norrath. God, do I love this game. God, do I love this game. We're going to have to play this during the winter, I think. Pop that baby in. Best action RPG series on the PS2. Resident Evil Outbreak. Do you know anything about this one? This was Resident Evil Online. You could play with other people. And you couldn't talk to each other. So that made it a little more terrifying. Oh, here's the Resident Evil 4 instruction manual. There you go. All right, we'll piece those together later. Okay. Siren. Siren is made by Sony. It's a survival horror game. Recently, it's been going up in price a little bit. Not crazy. Just got the game here. Game of the disc. I've never played it. And then finally, really shocked to see this guy, a little beat up, a little loved, but complete, Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance 2. Not easy to find. Not easy to find. The manual is a little beat up. How's the disc looking? Played, but not abused. It'll run. Very good. This is a very hard to find game. The value of this tends to jump around a little bit, but it jumps around on the high end. So this was pretty cool to find for $2. So that was, oh my god. Yeah, that's $14 on that stack. Not bad. A couple of AAA RPGs here for the PS2, an NES game I really like, believe it or not, and Paper Mario. That's not bad at all. Okay, finally, real quick, not that pleased with this, but you might like it. I was at a Goodwill, and very hard these days, even if you're not a PC fan like myself, to pass up big box RPGs or PC games, especially if they're well-known titles. We've got Half-Life Game of the Year Edition here in the big box. It says it now includes Team Fortress Classic. I believe I looked in these and everything was in there, but your guess is as good as mine, to be honest. And as you can see, the price here was $4. It's hard for me to spend $4 on a part of me really regrets making this purchase. But if anything, I'm probably going to give this to Bismuth and Pat, their PC guys, and it'll look nice on display. What'll also look nice on display is the original Tomb Raider in the pyramid box. Tomb Raider Gold, Game of the Year. It's pretty hot. This one was more expensive. This was $6. And again, probably too much. I can't believe I spent $10 on these two things. And then finally, this one's really sweet. You got Star Wars TIE Fighter, which was also $6. Beautiful box art. Beautiful. And this one is so old that it's not... Ooh, this is cool. This is cool. Anybody recognize that? LucasArts, that's... can't believe I forgot the name of that guy. Full Throttle. That was from Full Throttle. Yeah, it was one of their more well-known adventure PC games. But this guy's so old that this guy's on disc. Look at that. It's got the manual here. I don't know what we're going to do with this. Again, this is probably just decoration. You know, these are very hard to sell. You can probably sell them on eBay, but not for much more. And it's just a pain. I mean, these are... cardboard, they're, you know, you don't want to be sending them in just envelopes and they get ruined, and you know, you want to be shipping out good products. So we'll probably just put those maybe in the library, ship's library or something, just as decos. Yeah. All right, so that's it.
that's all we got today.
Let's get back to Barnyard. Still more to do, still more to see, and you're not going to believe how this wraps up, okay? All right, let's get started. It's, how's it? Looks like we got 14 minutes. Somewhere around 20 minutes. All right. It's Barnyard from the Nintendo GameCube. I'm a little worried that this music's gonna slam us, but, you know, royalties and whatnot. Probably shouldn't have used it, but it was very hard to not. Oh, I gotta get my headphones back. Oh, this is very... This game has some Animal Crossing elements in that, you know, it's kind of time-based. There's a day and night system, and there's resources around. Like right here, you can get an egg once a day. And as you can see earlier, we could use the egg for cooking. Maybe I could sell the chocolate mousse. I'm not really sure. Okay, now there was somewhere else I wanted to take us. Farther out. Actually, let's head out to Dankweed. Dankweed Pond. But if we're going to go all the way out there, we're going to go in style. Okay? What better way for a cow to travel than by bike? And let me tell you something. When I got this bike for the first time, I was in love. Like, just tooling around the countryside on a BMX bike, listening to banjo music. This was the best $3 I ever spent. I think I picked this up from a thrift store. It was the weirdest thing. I was dating somebody at the time. We left the thrift store. We were driving out. I've got this look on my face, and she's like, "Are you sure you're ready to go?" And I said, "Yeah, I think so." Oh, actually, let's head into the meadow. Ugh, get me out of here. There we go. And just tool around a little bit. So we're at a thrift store. We're in the car. We're ready to go, and I'm like, "Just give me a minute. Wait in the car." I go back to the video section and pick this up. I was gonna leave it behind. It's for the GameCube, but there was just something about it made me head back. And, for the next 2 weeks or so, I played all the way through this guy, and I just fell in love. You know, we've taken the ship out to Radiator Springs. Oh, a long time ago. And Radiator Springs is where the movie Cars takes place. We played Cars, the video game, that voyage. And it's really because of this game that I ever started looking for open world kids games. During this PS2, GameCube, and original Xbox era. This is so much fun. I do a wheelie. I think we're close to Dankweed. I can't, you know, if you ever see this game, grab it. That's all I have to say. Alright, I don't know what he's gonna make us do, but let's see. Hey, buddy. Have you seen my posse? They were gonna meet me here to go swimming today. I'm waiting on Pig, Pip, Pep, and Freddy. If you see any of them, could you send them down here? Oh, so this is just a fetch quest. Alright, well, if I see him, sure. So here's Dankweed Pond. If anybody was interested in it. I mean, and it's gorgeous. You know, let's take a look. Let's take a second and just take it in. Oh man, we gotta go walk that dock. And I did this a lot when I had this game. You know, you probably beat this game in about 3 hours, but I'm pretty sure I played it around 15. I loved it. I loved getting lost in this world. I'm gonna shoot some milk into the water. I'm also gonna try and hit Otis. Let's see if we can hit Otis from here. Oh, I think it would hit that. Oh, that's lovely. That's for you, April. Alright, I'm sorry. You taught me. I learned it from watching you. Alright, let's get back on our bike. I'm trying to think who made this. THQ made this. Toy Headquarters. And, I believe that's right. Yeah, THQ. I'm looking at the box here. Is this one of our friends? Who's this? Oh, yeah, here's the chicken. Hi.
Hello. Again.
Otis is looking for you. It's that time. You better go, man. Everybody else here? I'm on a time limit. I haven't noticed that. Okay, here's a couple others. Here's the pig. This is kind of boring, but all these missions are quick. And just taking in the scenery, taking it easy is so fun for me. Yeah, come on. Alright, so there's only one more, right? What? Oh, I gotta take him there? Alright, well, I'll take you there, but is anyone else here that I have to... Let's take a look here. Who is the other person? Oh, yeah, the weasel. Is he by the chicken coop? No, he's not. Wait, there he is. No, he's not. Alright, there's this weasel who's... he gave up eggs. So he's always just kinda... He's kinda like Steve Buscemi. He's got these big, big googly eyes. Let's see if we find him. But we'll take Pip out to Dankweed. Could you listen to this music for 15 hours? I gotta tell ya, I did. I did, and I loved it. Oh! Looks like one of our guys is here. There he is. There's Freddy.
How's it going?
Forgetting, yeah. Alright, you gotta go see Otis. Come on. So get over there, I'll drop off Pip, and then I think we're done. I sure hope so. Because there's something else I want to do. It's late in the day, and we're going to take a little nappy. Because, you know, we're doing the country living here. We shouldn't be too busy. So take a little nappy, and then we'll get ready for this evening's festivities. Oh yeah, everybody's here. There you go, pal. You're welcome. Alright, see you later. Go for bucks. Yes, there is an economy system in this. And we're gonna see, we talked about it. We mentioned the gophers earlier. Remember we made some butter for them. Well, we're gonna take a little nappy. And then we'll head back. And you'll notice I'm passing some fences here. They have locks on them. And what's that mean? That means there's whole other areas to explore in this world. And there's signs everywhere. Oh, we got it, dude. Hold on, before we go to bed. Yeah, before we go to bed. We're gonna run out of time! What? How are we doing out of time? Oh my god, we got 14 minutes. Alright, we gotta do this, though. There's no way we can't. So this is the Tease the Mailman game. Watch this. Pepper time! Is it challenging? No, but it's hilarious. Oh, the golf swing. I like that one. Oh, the ninja! We're gonna do the ninja. Sweet. muscle flex. Yeah, get it. Oh, the robot. How can you say no to the robot? Pharaoh. Oh, man. I love country living, huh? Maybe Bourbonnais not so bad after all. Okay. Oh, we already did that for time. Moonwalk, of course. Give it to me. To the Raging Bull. Cow Punch? Oh, we did that one already. Oh! Oh, okay. I thought he caught me. Okay. Alright, how we do on Fooling the Mailman? Hey, star is a good score. Excuse me. Lord. Alright. Okay, I see someone in the mess hall here mentioning Steve Odenkirk. Yeah, that's true. I should at least give a little credit to where this game came from. Look, I didn't know anything about Nickelodeon's Barnyard before. I got a text, but I'm ignoring it. We're gonna go take a nap. I'm sleepy. Before this game, I picked it up for $3 and fell in love with it. And that's when I realized, well, I realized that before, but I'd never seen this movie. And that's what this was. This was a kid's movie made about 10 years ago. They eventually made a series. And so all these characters are totally fleshed out. But for a guy like me, I knew nothing about this world. And if I could suggest a game to you that you didn't need another source material, it's Barnyard, okay? Now, what am I hearing? I'm hearing crickets. Well, let's just take it in a second, because it is gorgeous. You get lost in the scenery here. But I'm also hearing some music. And that's coming from the barnyard. Barn there. We've got 10 minutes. We're going to go see the gophers real quick. They live just over the bridge. And every night, the gophers come out. And you can trade with them with whatever money you've accumulated throughout the day. See, this guy's making deals. This is like Cap and Raz's domain right over here. Alright. So there's all kinds of stuff you can buy. And you can buy it for the barn. Why the barn? Because the whole end game of this game is to make a nightclub in the barn, okay? So you get all this furniture, you know, you can get booze, you got goat milk, stud molasses, smoothie maker, but of course, Cap and Raz is going to go for the fun and games. Now, we already bought the pool table. There's dartboards here, pinball machines. But I really think we should get the Bucking Human, don't you? Alright, we're buying the Bucking Human. Thanks, pal. Alright, great. Let's get back on our bike. And we'll head into the barn so you guys can get a gander at that. And I'll also show you my favorite thing, of which there are many, but definitely the thing that wowed me the most in Barnyard. Now, the gophers have already delivered our bucking human. Somebody's probably going to be on it already. I mean, it's a new ride. Good evening. All right, so the barn isn't much to look at right now, but as you saw, there's all kinds of stuff you can buy to fix this place up. But my main focus hasn't been up here and here where the bar is, but downstairs where the arcade is. I mean, who would have thought that an arcade, would be in this game about Yeah. Oh, now that's comedy. Woo! Alright, but let's head over here. Check it out. This is the farmer's dog. And what does he like to do? That's right, he likes to play pool. And I think we have just enough time to get one game in. And then we'll get a question or two in. And then we'll wrap up. I could play this all day. It's sloppy, it's far from precise. But I'm playing pool in the basement of a barn with a dog. Oh, come on! How did I foul? Because I got a yellow and a red? Yeah, that makes sense. Sunk! Ba-ba-na. Alright, so I'm yellow. Oh, wow, I don't have a shot anywhere. But I have two shots. So why don't I just try and hit this one to stop me so I have a better shot at the others. Alright. See if that pays off for me. Used to play a lot of pool back in college. Love the music. I'm always off key or off sync with the music that you're hearing, but it's hard for me to not sing along with it sometimes because the music in this game is really catchy. Guys, ever play what was it called? It was on PS3. It was PS3's MMO. PlayStation, it wasn't PlayStation Life. Do I get a second shot? Oh, no. PlayStation, they had an MMO where everybody was just humans and they'd walk around. But there was a bowling alley and then there was a pool table. There were pool tables. Oh, I can't let him do that. He's not very good either. He plays about as good as a dog does. Oh, that's a double scratch. 3 minute warning, Reyes. You better get those balls in. I'm still ahead by one. I guess he's got one all the way at the nose. Whoa! Nice shot! Where's this other ball? Oh! He scratched on it! Wait, that doesn't make... Yeah, I gotta go again. Oh, you put it right in my way, dude! PlayStation Home, thank you. Yeah, PlayStation Home at a bowling alley. And a pool table. Pool hall. Spent a lot of time in there. Oh my god. Now he's got two shots. Oh, really? Ugh. Stop. Oh, no. All right. If I can't get this one. A dog and a pirate walk into a bar. Ah! Go ahead, Duke, take it. It's all right. That's fine. Hey, you know what? You'll never beat me at mud jumpers. Wait, I won? How did I win? What, did he scratch? All right, I'll take your word for it. Sure, not bad. I don't know. It was pretty bad. Let's check the mess hall, see if anybody left a question here. No, not really. Okay. All right. Let's pull something from the mail bag. Okay. So, how much time? We don't have much time. Oh, we're just running out of time. Actually, we just went over time just now. Okay. Here's a question. When did I become a part of the crew? That's Loaded Ducky. This guy came into the mess hall around 3 in the morning one day, and I said, hey, crew, if you watch the show, you're a part of the crew. That's just how it works. If you've ever stepped through the door, you're a part of the crew. I mean, pirates weren't exactly, you know, picky about who they put on the ship. Most of the times they were taking people, you know, against their will. So Loaded Ducky, you're crewed up, whether you like it or not. Okay, that's it. We gotta go. Thanks a lot for joining me in Bourbonnais, Illinois. April, my sister, and all my family puts up with me. The city boy who comes into town and calls your town Bourbonnais and laughs because he thinks he's amusing. Thank you for putting up with me. All you crew out there, thanks for watching. Hope you had a good time. We'll see you next time for adventure, for laughs, for mystery, and for by God booty. Until then, I will an adieu to ye Spanish ladies. I will an adieu, ye ladies of Spain. For we received orders for to sail to Bourbonnais. Oh, God, I'm clever. And we may never see ye fair ladies again. Oh, mother's milk. Keep your powder dry, mateys.